Welcome, everybody. Bom dia, sejam bem-vindos. We are starting our webinar, Innovation Environment in Russia, Opportunities for Foreign Startups and Innovation Companies. My name is Yulia Mikhailova. I work in Apex Brazil Moscow office. Thank you very much for your interest. Let's get started. Innovation agenda has been among priorities for Russian government and private sector for a few years already. Now we see an increasing amount of opportunities for foreign startups and innovation companies. So we think that it's a great moment for a Brazilian innovation sector to search for opportunities in Russia. That's why today we gathered some key speakers that represent public and private innovation institutions of Russia, and we are excited to listen to them. Before we start, I would like to thank Brazilian Embassy in Moscow and Brazilian Foreign Ministry Special Program Diplomacia e Inovação for their support in organization and promotion of our webinar. Okay, let me introduce our speakers. Our first speaker will be Valentina Podgaina. She represents MTS Group, that is the biggest internet and mobile provider of Russia. And they have been developing some very interesting projects, including MTS Startup Hub. Hello, Valentina. Thank you very much for joining us today.
Hello. Thank you so much for inviting me today.
Okay. Our next speaker will be Daria Shunina. She is the head of International Startups Relations of Skolkovo Foundation, our Russian Silicon Valley. Hi, Daria. Thank you very much for joining us today.
Thank you very much. I'm so pleased to be the part of this great event. Thank you.
Okay. Our next speaker will be Andrei Bardin. He is the deputy head of international affairs of Moscow Agency of Innovations, but he's a little bit late, so he will join us a little bit later. And our last speaker will be Alvaro Augusto Guedes Galvani. He is the chief of public diplomacy, educational cooperation, and cultural promotion of Brazilian Embassy in Moscow. And he has already guided science, technology, and innovation sector of Brazilian Embassy. And he has a lot of interesting information to share with us. Hi, Alvaro. Bom dia.
Boa tarde, Yulia, para a gente. Bom dia para os amigos do Brasil. Privet, Vício. É um prazer estar aqui. Eu trabalho em coordenação com o Paulo há bastante tempo, então é com muito prazer e que eu posso compartilhar as informações que ele traria aqui para vocês. E gostaria de dizer também que é um assunto que me interessa muito. Eu trabalhei nesse setor durante 6 anos quando estive em Brasília. Muito obrigado pelo convite.
Okay, before we start our presentations, I would like to remind you that in our YouTube channel, we have a chat that you can use to leave your comments and make questions. After all the presentations, we are going to have 10-15 minutes for questions and answers. And please leave your comments in English. Okay, our first presentation will be from MTS Hub. But Valentina will have to leave a little bit earlier. But don't hesitate to leave questions for her. We will be sure to inform them to her and reply to you. Okay, Valentina, we're excited to see your presentation.
Great, and. Is everything okay?
Yes, cool. Great.
Great, thank you so much. So, hi everyone, once again. My name is Valentina. I'm a technology scout for MTS Startup Hub. A couple of words about MTS. Yes, we are the leading telecommunication group in Russia and CIS. And we build an ecosystem unifying more than 10 new non-telco business units such as financial services, industry 4.0, digital services, health, and etc., many other. MTS Startup Hub is the center for innovations and investment of MTS. The structure of center includes a corporate acceleration program launched 3 years ago. It's the MTS Corporate Venture Fund, 5G Center, and scouting offices, international scouting offices. During these 3 years, we've launched 71 pilots with significant results for our businesses. And speaking about international startups, we had many actually tools to provide the access to work with international startups and cooperate with them. First one is international scouting offices. As I said, we have three representatives in Germany, Israel, and Southeast Asia. Each representative is responsible for their region and work according to our accelerator batches needs and according to the request from our business units. Also, we have team in Sistema VC, team based in Bangalore. But the main thing that I would like to mention that I think according to our two previous batches, we had many startups actually from Brazil, and it's really cool. So yes, we're interested in South America also. The second part of activity is partnership program with the Russian and the foreign corporation, governments and the ecosystem players. And we have a kind of offer for each type of partner. So the main focus of interest are joint program for scouting and interaction with startups. It's collaborative innovations, different consulting and experience sharing. And now actually we have more than 200 partners all over the world with different focus of interest. As for international startups, I think we can offer them two main programs. Yes, it's corporate acceleration program or soft landing program. It's not about teaching startups how to do business. It's about piloting and integration in MTS ecosystem and fast track program for pilots. And the second program is 5G Center. We actively working with startups who can use 5G or can implement this technology. And we have incubation program in Moscow and 5G lab in St. Petersburg for more mature startups who actually has the 5G ready cases, and we can sell these cases together for current MTS clients. And actually, what can we give for our startups, right, during this program? Of course, MTS as a client, as we know, the biggest telco companies in Russia and CIS. So I think it's a pretty good client for our side. Of course, it's a product scaling on Russian market and the possibility of practical pilot projects on real MTS and MTS clients and MTS client base. Of course, it's commercial pilot and we have grants for product adaptation. It can be expert and hardware support from MTS and our partners again. Of course, it's PR support. And I think the most interesting thing is that it's full partnership with MTS in various ways as a contract, investment, hiring, share buyout, etc. And speaking about 5G, MTS is the only company on Russian market where you can come for free and get in a product and get any resources and services for product development. Speaking about criteria, yes, we are looking for startups. It's of course a finished product or MVP. And speaking about acceleration program and soft landing program, we're interested only in finished product. MVP is more interested for incubation program with 5G technologies. Of course, it's market side. Yes, it's team and it's product and sale. Some points about Accelerator. We do not take any equity fee. We only focused on piloting. Yes, we can cover some travel grants, of course, if a startup need for, you know, for process of piloting, some meetings with business units, etc. Oops. Oh, my presentation. Right. Yes, we have our own fast track process because you know that corporation is very difficult to launch any innovations, but we have a very good structured fast track process for any piloting. Of course, it's support as from our IT department, procurement, legal, etc. And of course, it's paid contract for our side, paid contract and paid pilots. I know some information about corporate venture fund. Yes, it's we have now two deals. Corporate venture fund 5G center. So have two batches, but now in progress, the third one. And actually, last month we opened 5G lab in St. Petersburg. So we are actively looking for startups, for mature startups who has 5G ready cases for our 5G lab in St. Petersburg. For cooperation, for contracting, and cooperation with MTS client who are interested in 5G ready case products. Some success stories. Actually, I send this presentation. You can look through information about some startups. Yes, and yeah, thank you so much. I would be very happy to answer any question, maybe to express more info about some points, and I'm looking forward to work with Brazilian startups.
Thank you very much, Valentina. Thank you so much. We will share your contacts with all the Brazilian startups that are listening to us now and with our database. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Bye-bye, Valentina. We know that you are in a hurry, so.
Yes, I'm so sorry, but I promised that I reply to any emails that I will have.
Thank you, we appreciate it.
Thank you so much.
Okay, our next speaker is Daria Shunina from Skolkova Foundation. Please, Daria.
So, hello, everyone. I'm really pleased, I would like to say it one more time, to be the part of this event. Let me share my screen with you, first of all. So can you see it? So today, probably yes. All our Brazilian companies will hear a lot about innovation, soft land, and all these keywords, and all of them are connected with the Russian ecosystem. So I will first introduce myself. In Skolkova Foundation, I am the head of the International Startups Relations. So basically, what does it mean? So I lead the Skolkova Soft Landing Program, and I am responsible for all international companies who come to Skolkova and who want to expand to the Russian market. So probably you have already known some facts about the Russian market, about the Russian. I will make a quick overview. So currently, Russia is the sixth largest economy by purchasing power parity. It is the 11th largest economy by the nominal GDP. We have a very attractive tax system in comparison with other countries where you have a progressive tax system. We have a flat tax system. For example, a personal rate tax is 13% and it's stable. We have a lot of different economic zones in Russia where you can get certain tax benefits or customs preferences. We do have a very high level of scientific and technological development. And why is it good for you? Because first of all, you can hire a lot of professionals for your companies if you're willing to expand. Especially we're talking about such spheres as engineering or IT professionals. In Russia, the salaries are lower, I would say, than in Europe or in the United States. However, the quality of the specialists is really high. Also, we are a very big state, and despite the fact that many people think that we are only Slavic, we do have around 170 ethnic groups. So we are a multinational state in some way. Moscow is the capital of Russia. I'm sure you know it. But what I would like to say about Moscow is that it's a huge, large city. It's one of the largest cities in the world and in Europe, with a population over 12 million people, and is the city that never sleeps. And I'm not talking about nightlife right now, but I'm talking about the opportunities that are available for you in terms of living in Moscow or doing business in Moscow. Whenever you want to buy milk or bread, you can go to the supermarket that works 24 hours 7 days a week, or to the mall. So everything is available and open really for long hours. This year, Russia was ranked among the top 30 countries in the World Bank's Doing Business rating. So this is a special rating that evaluates business environment. And we are doing pretty good. Right now we are on the 27th place, and we're going better and better. If we talk about Skolkovo Innovation Center, so this is the biggest innovation center in Russia and in Europe. This is a real territory for innovation, a small innovation village. I would love to encourage you to visit Skolkovo Innovation Center one day, and I would love to make a guide tour for you. I'm sure you would love it. So, but right now I will tell you some facts about it. So this is a large innovation hub that has a territory of 400 hectares. So we even use shuttles and small buses to go from one building to another. We have around 3,000 startups right now. They are very diverse and very interesting. So networking is our strong facility that we have in Innovation Center. We have a lot of R&D centers. We have many different industrial partners from different spheres. We have everything that a startup or a company may need for living and working. We have kindergarten, we have school, we have apartments for rent, labs, offices, tennis courts, swimming pools. So basically everything that you need, you can find in this city. So basically, if you want to do business in Russia, come to Skolkovo and you can start living and working right from this day. Yeah, so this is a small advertisement. So no, but really, honestly, we do have a lot of different opportunities. Our Technopark is pretty huge, and we have a lot of things that you can use for your business, not only offices and laboratories, but also hack spaces, common use centers, and co-working. In Skolkovo, all our startups are divided by four main areas. We call these areas clusters. Basically, they are very broad, and I'm sure that all of you can fit into one of these four. The first one is biomedical cluster. So these are companies related to agriculture, medicine, or cosmetics. Another one is IT. So here we have a wide range of different directions. This is one of the most popular clusters currently. It is legal tech, fintech, AI, IoT, and so on and so forth. Another cluster is energy efficient. So these are all the projects related to natural resources, oil, gas, and so on, to smart city or smart homes, and to environmental solutions. So right now the eco theme is trending in Russia. And another one is from tech, but this is like a Russian name. In English, we can translate it as advanced industrial cluster. So these are technologies related to different materials, nanomaterials, to telecommunications and nuclear technologies. So, and in Skolkovo, we usually help Russian companies to go global. We support local companies, we promote their products and so on. However, 2 years ago, we realized that there was a big demand from foreign companies who wanted to expand their business to the Russian market, but they didn't know what to start with. So they called us, they sent us some emails, hey guys, help us, what to do, how to start your business. And we decided that being such a great window for innovations in Russia, we need to launch a special program. And we launched a special soft landing program for foreign companies. So basically we help you to land in Russia softly without stress. So what does it mean? Before the pandemic, this program was absolutely offline, and we invited companies to come to Russia, Moscow, to Technopark for 2 weeks The program is absolutely free of charge, and we provided an office, a special place in co-working for up to 1 month, because we understand that flight tickets, rent, it all takes money. So in order to make it easier for you, we provided a free place in a co-working space. Even now, if some of you have visas or you have an opportunity to travel, you can join the program and come to our co-working and work there for free. As currently in Russia, we do not have any restrictions. All our public areas are open. However, after the pandemic, we needed to change the format, and we moved our program from offline into online format. And right now it's a 1 week program, basically even 5 days. It starts on Monday, it finishes on Friday, where we give you information about different things that you need to know. So we give you lectures and seminars about law issues, about how to open legal entity in Russia, about how to find your workers, about HR, about GR, about different events, about startup community in Russia. So we try to make it short, interesting, and very clear, so you're not too bored during these 5 days, but you get the information that you really need and that is really useful. If we talk about the time, basically it takes about 2-3 hours a day to participate in the program. It will be in Zoom. And in the end of each week, we have a big pitch session for all companies where we invite our experts from particular spheres. For example, we do 1 day for IT, 1 day for medicine companies, and so on and so forth. And we also invite different representatives from development institutions, corporations, business angels, or some investors even. And after this pitch session, we provide a written feedback about your company, whether your technology is ready to go to the Russian market or not. So we give all this information to you. Except this, we try to integrate you into our community. If we have some events, we always try to make you join them. For example, the next cohort of the soft landing program that you can join will start on the 31st of May till the 4th of June. It will be, again, absolutely free of charge. The deadline, I think, is till the May 20 when you can apply. On May 24th, 25th, we're going to have a really big and important event for Skolkovo. It is called Startup Village. It's a huge open-air conference for about innovations. And right now it will be in a digital format. So it will be and physical and digital for those who cannot come to Russia. If you do have this opportunity, so I'm inviting you to come and join us. You can present your projects, you can participate. It's a great opportunity for networking and just simply for relaxing, having fun and enjoying the beautiful weather. Usually we have it by the lake. And for those, the participation in Startup Village is not free. However, for their soft landing program participants, we provide tickets for free. So it means that in May, it will be a great opportunity for you to participate in the Startup Village. For example, if you can't come, you can participate online and you can participate in an online exhibition, show your project. And after that, you can join the Skolkovo soft landing program as well. Some of the conditions that you need to know, usually we have the program 3 times a year, March, summer, it's June or May and October. When it was offline, we had a limit for 3 participants from the company. Right now we have no limits. You can apply online. Here is the link, or you can just text me and I will send you the link one more time. And the main goal that in the end of the program, you can realize and understand for yourself whether you want to go to the Russian market or you don't need it. You do not have any obligations. This program is for you to understand the market and how it works, to understand what support measures we provide. If you're not interested in this, in the end, you can just go back to your routine and come back to us maybe later in some years. We had these cases as well. Or if you understand that, yes, it's time and you are ready, you can apply for Skolkovo resident status. So what is this? Oh, I said that we have 3,000 startups. All these startups have the Skolkovo resident status. It means that you need to fill in a special application form and get accepted. It's also free of charge. And when you're accepted, you need to open a legal entity in Russia and you can operate as a company and you can get a lot of benefits. So these benefits, I think, are available only from Skolkovan. The main benefits are tax benefits, obviously. So these are profit tax zero, exemption from VAT, property tax zero, insurance premiums. Usually they're around 30% in Russia. Here you pay 14%. You also can apply for grants. These are free money that you can use to develop your product, make prototypes, and so on and so forth. You get business development opportunities. So every company gets the personal project manager who track your process, help you to develop your product, and so on and so forth. You get access to our mentors, investors, partners, and you participate in all important events. And also for all companies and foreign and Russian, we have a lot of fee-based services. These are services like legal entity opening, patenting, HR services, and so on and so forth. A huge range of different services. So these are some of the pictures of the program when we had it offline. So it's like a nice nostalgia from my side because it's a special atmosphere when you can meet in person. However, the online format is also pretty successful and I would say pretty useful. I can say that we have already had 8 programs and 170 companies from 40 countries have participated. I think we didn't have many companies from Latin America. We have maybe one from Chile and maybe around 6 or 7 from Brazil. And we were really impressed by the quality and the ideas that companies presented. So that's why we are really delighted and we are open for new Brazilian companies to come and join our program to share your brilliant and fantastic ideas with us. And we are ready to help and to support you. So to summarize, again, we invite you to join our soft landing program. If you're a foreign company who are interested in getting more information about Russia or who is sure that they want to go to the Russian market, where you can get general information about main things in Russia and you can get our support. The program is free of charge and the next launch is on May 31st. Here are my contact details in case you have any questions or need some support or help. You can always contact me anytime. And in the end, let's innovate with meaning together in Skolkovo. Thank you very much, guys. It was my pleasure.
Thank you, Daria. I want to participate in your soft landing program.
Join! Join us!
Okay, thank you very much. I would like to invite now Andrei Bardin, the Deputy Head of International Affairs of Moscow Agency of Innovations. Hi, Andrei. Thank you very much for joining us.
Hi, everyone. Thanks for having me. I present the Moscow Agency of Innovations. This is an innovative arm of Moscow city government. So we are a subsidiary organization of the Department of Entrepreneurship and Innovative Development of the City of Moscow. I will be very brief since we already heard a lot about Russia. I will speak directly about Moscow, what Moscow, the government of Moscow has to offer. So as you very well know, while startups, innovative companies are highly dynamic, they also experience rather serious problems in dealing with the city administration and with large corporations. Moscow Agency of Innovations is currently operating 2 programs that could be useful for innovative companies, primarily for startups. And we invite Brazil companies to participate in both these programs. So please display the presentation. The first program is called a Moscow Innovation Pilot Program. Both programs are aimed at solving the problems that startups experience in dealing with the city and large corporations. Next slide, please. So basically, what are these problems? The biggest problem is that startups are very often poorly familiar with the real needs of a city and real needs of large corporations. Also, startups often experience difficulty in proving the economic viability of their products to the city administration as a large customer and to the corporations. Also, you very well know that dealing with city is difficult because it has a complicated public procurement system, which is sometimes almost impossible to deal with. The program, Moscow Innovation Pilot Program, was designed to overcome these difficulties. So it's basically a service for technology companies that allows them to test their innovative products and solutions on more than 90 public and private urban sites in the city of Moscow. The program is, what is most important, it's a market entry tool for innovative companies to enter the Russian market, market of the city of Moscow, and also greater Eurasian market. You can test your innovative solution on various facilities as pilot testing sites, where representatives of these facilities, together with experts from industry and from the city, will help you understand how economically viable your product is. They will assess your solution and provide recommendations. Also, you will receive feedback from the citizens which will be the potential customers. Yeah, thank you. Next slide, please. So here you can see that there are various spheres that your solution could be, from sport to food tech. Next slide, please. Yeah. So basically what you need to know is that the city administration will guide you through all the stages of the process. It will receive your application for the program and assess whether there is a right pilot testing site in the city of Moscow for you. So it will connect you with this facility, and together you will elaborate a procedure, a methodology for piloting your solution in Moscow. Then you will receive a follow-up report from the experts and from the city with recommendations how you could develop your solution further. Next slide, please. Yeah. So here are various examples of requests from the city for the technologies from the startups. Of course, it allows all the key technologies like deep tech, AR, VR, etc. Next slide, please. Yeah. So corporations are also very active. They are active partners of the city of Moscow, and they also have their tasks. As you very well know, corporations are eager to expand their innovative ecosystem, to integrate new products into their ecosystem. So it's a good opportunity for foreign startups to enter the Moscow market. We have partners from retail to e-commerce to fintech, etc. Next slide, please. Yeah, so for international projects, we can offer a variety of various pilot sites. For example, we have a number of technology parks that can provide you with all the number of opportunities from laboratories to, you know, displaying your solution to the larger public. Another example is Lenta Retail Company. So you can test your solution if you have, for example, solution that helps to detect the goods on the shelves of a retail company. You could also test it here in Moscow. Next slide, please. Yeah, another example is a telecommunication sphere and transport. So we have very large pool of partners. Therefore, I think practically each participant of the present session could find an appropriate pilot testing site to test his or her development. So we heartily invite you to participate in the program. It is free of charge. Of course, we will guide you through all the stages of the process. And at the end of the presentation, we have contact data, how to participate in it. And yeah, we will provide you a presentation, of course. We have a QR code here. And please display the next presentation. The next presentation is devoted to the Project Moscow Accelerator. And I will begin with a point that this project has won the BRICS Best Solution Award as in the spheres of entrepreneurship. So this is an international contest of BRICS countries, and the Moscow Accelerator was regarded as the best solution in the sphere of collaboration of city and entrepreneurs. So, thank you. So basically, Moscow Accelerator is a program that bridges the gap between the city, startups, and corporations. But if the first program was aimed at piloting and testing your solution, this program is like any accelerator aimed at improving your solution. And it also includes the piloting sphere. So after you pass the accelerator program, you can also pilot your solution. Next slide, please. So why is this program interesting for you? Because you can get direct expertise from the experts of the Moscow City Administration and from the largest Moscow corporations. Moscow Accelerator is a series of industry accelerators in various spheres, in fintech, in retail, etc. And each track of accelerator is run in partnership with one of the largest Moscow corporations. So this corporation formulates some requirements for the technology solutions it looks after. And while it is interested in growing up innovative solutions that meet their requirements, they provide the best expertise and the best support for these companies. So each track of a Moscow Accelerator is 10 weeks of intensive practice. It is practical workshops, masterclasses, traction meetings, and also individual consultations with trackers. Next slide, please. Yeah, here are some numbers. I won't bore you with all these numbers. You could, if you are interested, check them later. But I will only mention that the program gained huge attention from the Moscow entrepreneurial system. And we received hundreds and hundreds of applications for it. And the companies that passed the Moscow Accelerator, they showed some really impressive results. So as you understand, they not only receive a prize, which is rather large, but they also receive really good support in entering the international market. In this case, the Eurasian market. Next slide, please. Yeah, so for example, for this year, we already launched the track for future bank technologies. And we are planning also the following spheres in digital health, in prop tech, sport tech, and also you could offer your personal track. So I mean, we are open for suggestions, not only from startups, but also from corporations. And we would would be very happy to see not only small enterprises and startups as participants of our accelerator, but also large corporations as partners of a separate track run in cooperation with Moscow government. So basically, that was the most important information. On the last slide, you can find contact data to participate in the project. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so and should you have any questions, I'm very eager to answer them. That's it.
Thank you very much, Andrei. Thank you. It was very interesting. Okay, and our last but not the least speaker is Alvaro Galvani from the Brazilian Moscow, from the Brazilian Embassy in Moscow. Hello, Alvaro. Bom dia. He will speak Portuguese, if you allow, guys, with our Brazilian audience, okay?
Okay.
Здравствуйте, Дарья. Long time no see you. Eu tive o prazer de visitar a escola que a Dária nos recebeu e fez toda a apresentação, todo o time da embaixada, inclusive autoridades brasileiras que vieram posteriormente. É sempre um prazer revê-los. Obrigado, Yulia, mais uma vez. A minha fala hoje é para mostrar as atividades do Ministério das Relações Exteriores do Brasil nessa área da ciência e da tecnologia. Há mais de uma década, o Itamaraty monitora esse tema com bastante atenção. Nós criamos lá atrás, selecionamos algumas embaixadas para que houvesse um setor de ciência e tecnologia. Sempre um diplomata e mais uma equipe dedicada para monitorar oportunidades de cooperação em alguns países-chave. Esse esforço ele é dinâmico, então ele tem se transformado em seu formato, nas formas de apoio, e ampliado. Isso, a forma mais contemporânea disso, é o que eu gostaria de dizer com mais profundidade agora, é o que nós chamamos de Programa de Diplomacia da Inovação, uma iniciativa da Chancelaria Brasileira, e que eu posso trazer agora alguns números comparando 3 anos seguidos para vocês perceberem uma ênfase crescente nessa ação. Em 2019, por exemplo, havia 35 postos com setores dedicados à ciência e tecnologia e buscando apoio à atividade de inovação, especialmente nesse diálogo de facilitar a aproximação de startups e agências de apoio em países estrangeiros, ou o diálogo entre startups, onde pudesse haver alguma sinergia. Em 2020, essa rede de postos subiu para 43 postos, e em 2021 nós temos agora 49 postos que eu digo são embaixadas ou consulados do Brasil no exterior, que estão diretamente envolvidas com instruções para lidar com apoio à diplomacia. Como vocês percebem, isso é uma grande capilaridade no plano internacional, acho que isso é um dos pontos fortes desse nosso programa. Um outro diferencial é que esse time está sempre em diálogo com os setores de promoção comercial. A gente sabe que inovação caminha junto com a promoção comercial, então o diálogo interinstitucional é muito importante. E, por fim, o Itamaraty tem também a vantagem de um grande leque de parceiros dentro do Brasil, interlocução com várias instituições. A Apex Brasil é uma delas, mas a gente fala com muita fluidez com o Ministério da Ciência e Tecnologia, FINEP, Amprotec, diversos parques tecnológicos. Então, é uma ação de apoio à inovação que parece rica e está à disposição para os benefícios das startups brasileiras. Eu queria, para não ficar apenas na teoria, eu gostaria de dar exemplos concretos também. Em 2019, foram 100 startups brasileiras receberam algum tipo de apoio à internacionalização por meio desse programa da Diplomacia e Inovação. Em 2020, esse número dobrou, nós atingimos o apoio a 200 startups. E 2021, ainda em curso, com toda a dificuldade da pandemia, nós tivemos adaptação para uma série de ações que nós faremos presencialmente, obviamente fazendo agora online, mas não deixamos de promover, de buscar abrir esses caminhos, né? Essas oportunidades. Eu creio que agora eu poderia dizer um pouco da diplomacia que nós temos feito aqui na Rússia, né? Em que medida esse programa de diplomacia da inovação, que no último ano também tem se aproximado com o que a gente chama de diplomacia da saúde, né? Em que medidas nós podemos cooperar com outros países para atacar a questão da pandemia, com o combate à pandemia. Mas na Rússia, nos últimos anos, a gente tem desenvolvido algumas atividades e conseguido resultados concretos que eu queria compartilhar com vocês. A própria colega Daria, da Skolkova, mencionou que já são 7 empresas brasileiras que foram recebidas em programas da Skolkova e passaram uma boa impressão. E essa é com grande gratificação que a gente nota que, de fato, as empresas startups brasileiras surpreendem os russos, né? Nós identificamos que
tanto a Rússia para o Brasil um pouco exótico e o Brasil para a Rússia um pouco exótico. E, geralmente, esse canal de identificação não passa pela ciência e tecnologia. E quando esse encontro acontece nesse setor, é sempre uma surpresa positiva. Eu acho que isso é um fato importante que espero que sirva de incentivo para as startups brasileiras conhecerem o ambiente de mercado de cooperação com a Rússia. Mas trazendo exemplos concretos do trabalho da embaixada nesse setor. Em 2018, nós realizamos, em dezembro de 2018, realizamos uma missão de ciência e tecnologia com a presença de representantes de 3 parques tecnológicos brasileiros, Porto Digital, Parque Tecnológico da UFRJ e o Parque Tecnológico de São José dos Campos. Eles vieram aqui à Rússia, visitamos diversos parceiros, visitamos a Skolka, visitamos outros parques tecnológicos como o Calibre, visitamos universidades e dali aprofundamos a ideia do objetivo que nós temos maior, que é o apoio ao soft landing da empresa brasileira que quer ter uma experiência no mercado russo e também a perspectiva de incubação cruzada. Como a parceria institucional entre parques tecnológicos podem permitir a incubação de empresas brasileiras aqui e de empresas russas aí no Brasil. Muitas vezes a sinergia dessas parcerias pode gerar negócios positivos de ambos os lados e facilita até cooperações de mais longo prazo. Então, isso é importante que fique no radar e saber que a embaixada está sempre disposta a facilitar o diálogo, a apoiar. A embaixada, falo isso em nome, claro, de todos os colegas, é uma diretriz do embaixador da chancelaria, nós não temos nenhuma pretensão de centralizar o poder de escolhas entre qual startup participa ou não, esse não é nosso papel. Nosso papel é abrir canais de diálogo, facilitar o diálogo e apoiar, na medida do possível, as ações que chegam a um termo concreto. Um outro exemplo de ação efetiva da embaixada, nós divulgamos ainda em 2019 o Prêmio Brasil Tech Award, em parceria com um parque tecnológico aqui em Moscou chamado Calibre. A Rússia surpreendeu, isso foi ser um prêmio organizado no Brasil para todo mundo, com inscrições de todo mundo, de países, startups de diferentes países. A Rússia surpreendeu sendo o quarto país com maior número de startups inscritas e entre os finalistas, 2 empresas eram russas, o que mostra aí um potencial que também pode surpreender o público brasileiro e pode estimular aí a curiosidade de vocês a encontrar potenciais parceiros na Rússia para uma cooperação, sinergia, cooperação comercial, ciência e tecnologia. Em maio de 2020, já, nós apoiamos a participação brasileira na Startup Village, como programa mencionado pela Dária também. Dois representantes brasileiros, André Botelho Bastos, da Fintech Rebel, e o Victor Magani, presidente da Associação Brasileira Offline to Online. Eles participaram de maneira remota, em razão da pandemia, mas tiveram acesso à riqueza que é esse evento, que reúne startups e representantes governamentais da Rússia inteira. A gente falou muito de Moscou hoje, mas a Rússia é um país enorme, com várias cidades interessantes. Kazan é um núcleo que é uma capital que investe muito em ciência e tecnologia. São Petersburgo também famosa por isso, Nova Sibirsk, que já mais na Sibéria, tem uma feira anual na área de TI que é muito prestigiada. Então, é um grande campo a ser identificado, eu ia dizer explorado, mas eu quero achar outra palavra, eu acho que é um grande campo de parceria para ser conhecido, né? Para ser adentrado pelas empresas brasileiras. E eu queria anunciar que
agora em maio desse ano, então no próximo mês, haverá um, organizaremos um novo webinar sobre o setor de agritech, né? Tecnologia, empresas agrícolas para o setor de agricultura, envolvendo startups de Brasil e Rússia. Essa é uma área que nós acreditamos tem grande potencial, a gente aproveita também de todo, anda lado a lado, né, e se ampara um pouco nos esforços da Apex Brasil, no escritório da Apex Brasil em Moscou, que agora em abril concluiu uma rodada de negócios nessa área de maneira esplendorosa, de máquinas e equipamentos do setor agrícola, que resultou em um grande número de contratos, com grande valor agregado envolvido. E a gente acha que Brasil e Rússia são produtores agrícolas naturais. O Brasil tem mais projeção mundial nisso, mas a Rússia, nos últimos 5 anos, cresceu de maneira impressionante, ampliando as áreas de agricultura e também modernizando já a estrutura de agricultura que eles têm. E, nesse sentido, nós, no Brasil, temos muita pesquisa e desenvolvimento nessa área, competência, prática em colocar isso no mercado, essas inovações no mercado. E a gente acha que fazer parcerias aqui com a Rússia, fazer negócios com a Rússia, nessa área de agritech, pode ser um grande experiência de sucesso. E a agritech é mais evidente, mas diversas áreas tem grande potencial. A Rússia é um país bastante urbano também, soluções para cidades, é algo que seria sempre bem-vindo, há muito espaço de diálogo entre os russos. Né? Nós temos os nossos desafios, aí o desenvolvimento de uma cultura, né, cada vez mais contínua, né, para que essa promoção da ciência, da tecnologia, da inovação brasileira seja percebido como algo de forma contínua. Né? Nós fazemos isso, temos feito isso, acho que a gente está próximo de conseguir agregar a imagem positiva que o Brasil tem aqui na Rússia, agregar também essa imagem de um país inovador, criativo e que sabe fazer negócio e de confiança, um parceiro de longo prazo, né? que quer parcerias, quer inovação tecnológica num jogo de ganha-ganha. Não quer só explorar, quer fazer sim um jogo de ganha-ganha. Então, desculpe se eu me alonguei e muito obrigado, Yuli. Obrigado a todos.
Muito obrigada, Álvaro. Muito obrigada mesmo. Thank you, Álvaro. We have some time for questions, and I would like to ask Daria and maybe Andrei to inspire our Brazilian companies and tell us about some success stories of foreign companies that participated in your programs. Daria, maybe you can tell us something about it.
Yeah, sure. So success stories, we're talking about the foreign companies, right? So if we're talking about foreign companies, as I told you, we had 170 companies from 40 different countries. Obviously, we didn't expect that all of them will apply and will go to the Russian market. However, right now we have around 30 companies who have made a decision to go to the Russian market and together with Skolkova. So to be precise, I think we have 29. Most of them, I think, are European. We have some companies from Asia, especially India. We have many companies from India, from China. So about 30 of them are applying, and 6 of them have already received the status of Skolkova participants. So they already getting these benefits, these special benefits. And they have just opened their offices in Russia after this whole pandemic situation. And right now they have hope, and we also hope that their business will be successful, and slowly, slowly they will start growing their sales here. Yeah. So in general, I can make a conclusion that those companies who were thinking about the Russian markets in the beginning and who were sure about that, so they are in the market and they are working actively to build their business here.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Daria. Andrei, do you have something to share with us, some success case?
Well, currently, we are only entering the international phase regarding these two programs. They were coined as primarily a tool for Moscow entrepreneurs. And while they proved to be very successful and sought after, now we decided to open them for international participants. So for now, we have a pool of applications for these programs. And as soon as we have some success cases, I will report them to you. But for now, it's a work in progress.
Perfect, perfect. We wish you all the success with your new program.
Yeah. Yulia, and can I also add, I just wanted to say that all of these representatives and Andrei, for sure that we are all like, I can say that we're all one big team, like we're not like competitors, so we're all here to help you, we're friends, we know each other, we try to support, and whenever you decide to ask help from Andrei or from us, we all share information about each other with great pleasure.
Thank you. Thank you. Yes, that was what our aim is, to present to our Brazilian companies the whole pool of the institutions that can support them in the Russian market. Thank you very much once again, Valentina, that has left us, Daria, Andrei, Alvaro, and the audience. I'm sure that our webinar was very interesting and useful, and our Brazilian companies we are sure that it will help them to launch some exciting projects, and we will hear about them soon. Thank you very much. Now I will have two organizational moments that I would like to present in Portuguese, just to be very clear for our companies, okay?
Sure.
Eu gostaria de lembrar que no YouTube há um link para a pesquisa de satisfação. É uma prática da Apex Brasil para sempre melhorar os nossos projetos. No final do webinar, eu também vou compartilhar uma tela com o código QR que vocês poderão usar para acessar essa pesquisa. E por último, eu gostaria de dizer que esse webinar foi gravado e será disponibilizado junto com todas as apresentações, seus contatos dos nossos speakers, para que todos que não conseguiram assistir o webinar possam ter acesso aos conteúdos. Obrigada. Thank you very much once again. Bye-bye, everybody. Bye-bye. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Bye, guys. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Das vidania.
Das vidania.